get the URL on, get the website domain name on. I thought it was just so darn original, and it was because I had met some fellows from the backwoods of Pennsylvania that invented things, and they were very proud of being hillbillies. They said, that's what we are, and we're proud of it, and you don't like it? Well, have a glass of shine and shut up. So anyway, I was going to do this.
I was going to say, see you on the hill.
See you on the hill. And we were going to do this this treatment for them about their skill at inventing. And we were going to call it Skillbillies. What a great title, right?
I like that.
So I go out on Skillbillies, and I go to see if I can help them get the domain name for that. And there's a band called Skillbillies. There's a clothing line called Skillbillies. Oh, my gosh. It's everywhere. It's everywhere. Yeah. So there are very few really original names left.
You know, I think my next facility will be, I'm going to get a silo in Vermont, you know, and just, I'll build a studio there, and I can have maple syrup to fund everything, all the projects.
Right. So there's a book series, a mystery book series that involves a man who's a former publisher or something, and he lives with two Siamese cats in a silo, and he adapted it to this very ultra-modern, multi-level home. And the cats have crisscrossing cat walkways all the way up to the top of the silo. Just a piece of trivia for the day. There.
Yeah.
Anyway, so they can make amazing, amazing structures out of those. Yeah.
I think the creativity of your location, I think it all kind of gives you that extra energy when you're there. You got to have a really cool place to be creative. You know, whether it's a closet or a bedroom or a silo, I think if it's part of your artistic expression, it helps you to work, helps you to develop.
Well, you help. Speaking of the word help, makes me think of your coaching. You've been a life coach. How is your, is it the Daily Coach, is that right?
It's called the Daily Life Coach.
Daily Life Coach.
Yes.
And it's global.
It's global. It's in 35 countries and a huge following. As a matter of fact, we start our next season, begins in 2 weeks. So we'll be back on the air with new episodes. And we also have a show that's a little edgier, a little more creative. It's called Powered Up.
And it's
all things powerful. So those powerful moments in everyone's life where they either made a transition or made a movement or whatever it may be. Mm-hmm. It's a cool show. It's a cool concept. Even like really different things. Like we're looking for some individuals who have used the power of the mind.
Ooh.
How far does that go? I want to see someone bend a spoon. Like a
Yuri
big
Geller,
spoon. Yeah,
right?
Maybe even a shovel. I don't know. I want some really strong minds to be on the show to do some things that are out of the box.
Well, you know, it's fascinating that so much research has been done for so many, 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 many decades about how little of our brain we know what it does.
My wife says that all the time about me.
And look what you've accomplished. If you could tap into 100%.
If I can release more than the 2%.
No, but the average human uses between 10 and 13% of their actual brain. And the other 87% is either unknown as to how it functions or so involuntarily functioning that you have no control over it. It's autonomous and acts on its own. What would happen if we could tap into the whole 100%? Maybe we'd be levitating things. I don't know. Maybe we'd be reading minds and, you know, that it's a pretty
So there was a movie about that.
At least a few.
a couple years back. And it was really good. She actually became energy itself. And
that was Scarlett Johansson.
Lucy was the
yes.
movie. There we go.
Yeah, and eventually she just completely dissolved into the energy form. It was kind of like a petroleum product, I believe, in the end. She was rolling across the floor in black globules, if I remember right.
If I could have refined that, you know, we could have made some money with that refining.
Yeah. Well, there was a movie about that, too, which was The Smart Pill, which gave you limitless, I think that's what it was called, limitless IQ. Yeah, it's a very interesting thing. But I just, you know, my own theories about it are completely amateurish, but I think about when you meet someone, like they used to refer to them as savants. I think they still probably do, but they're people that have challenges. Some of them have mental challenges, or they have societal challenges, or they have phobias, or whatever it might be. They may be challenged on one level, but they have abilities that are so amazing.
Absolutely.
And so out of the norm, whether it's being able to sit down at a piano and play a concerto with never having learned music, or to be able to do mathematics into 37 decimal points to complete perfect accuracy, or to be gifted with art, or to be gifted with music. A lot of them are creative arts that they've tapped into that almost compensate for some of the challenges that they may have otherwise.
Right.
And I just believe that they're tapping into some of that percentage we're not, because it's kind of like if you injure a part of your body, or if a part of your body is damaged, your body compensates.
Absolutely.
You'll be strong. If you injure your right arm, you'll learn to be strong in how to use your left arm. Or if you injure one leg, you will rely harder on the other. Or same thing with, I think it's the same thing with our brain. I think if a part
Absolutely.
Of it may be injured or damaged or challenged in any way, some other part is going to step up to the fore and take over.
Yeah.
Compensate. It's pretty interesting stuff.
Well, I'm looking forward to learning more about that.
Yeah. So those are the people you're going to be looking for.
Absolutely.
So have you put out any kind of talent calls yet? Or
we're actually going to start that next week.
Ah.
So we'll be looking for co-host and cast and some individuals for the show. And so we'll have the Daily Life Coach in production at the same time as Powered Up, and but it'll be two different shows. I think Powered Up's almost like next level.
Mm-hmm.
The Daily Life Coach is amazing because we have entrepreneurs and CEOs and very successful people, and we talk about varying forms of success and how to obtain them. And Powered Up is really going to be focused on just all things powerful, just really big things that are happening, going to happen, or how to control and navigate and harness power in any form.
I feel like doing, home improvement slogan where Tim Allen's character was like, more power, ar, 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 more power, more power. But I think that's true in life.
Yeah.
More power.
Absolutely.
And self-empowerment. That's a huge thing. I've always been a big believer in finding where your skills are.
Sure.
And finding your gifts. And if you can utilize what your aptitudes are, what your gifts are, that empowers you.
Well, I think a lot of people have to surrender to what's already in their mind. Most people already know the recipe or the map or the way to get there, but they don't trust it. They don't count on it. So take production, for example. You might want to make a film. And, when you read a book, it says, okay, here's how you develop it. Here's how you lock down your intellectual property. You go to production for 21 days. And you have your pickup days. You could do this, you do this. And it's like, we read this book, and that's what we want to follow.
A formula. Now.
But our budget or our crew may not give us the ability to do that. So now, instead of saying this should happen in a 67-day window, maybe it has to happen in a 367-day window, and we have to do it in sections. But, you can still get it made.
That's right.
And so a lot of individuals just need to look at things and go, what can I do, or what's my variation of modifying this process that I can still see the same result? Maybe it's delayed by 300 days, but it's the same results and the same success nonetheless.
Right. And are you willing to make it the best it can be? If it does mean you have to forego instant gratification to fit inside your little time window or your perfect timeline or that little box that you've already put it in your own mind.
Absolutely.
Can you set aside your little box, and can you make it work the right way?
Most people forego the creativity and the quality for the timeline, and that's the biggest problem.
Right.
Because they think if they have it faster, that it's going to sell quicker. That's not the case.
Well, I'm sure you, in as many businesses as you've been involved in, you've seen that triangle, right? And the top says fast, and the bottom right corner says good, and the bottom left corner says cheap.
Absolutely.
And you say to your client, you can pick two.
Yeah.
You can't have all three.
Yeah.
You can do it fast and good, but it won't be cheap. You can do it cheap and fast, but it won't be good. I think that's really true in the creative arts.
Absolutely.
So. Well, and you have also, I remember early on, back when we first met a dozen years ago, you were doing PSAs, you were doing
yes.
public service announcements.
Absolutely.
I mean, you have really been...
Voice acting, yeah.
Yeah.
Stay busy.
Finding the things that hone your craft.
Yes.
You were even an on-camera panel judge, I believe, in a reality show.
Yeah.
Are we allowed to talk about that?
Yeah. That was Pregnant in Heels on Bravo Television.
Pregnant in Heels.
Yeah. Right. Rosie Pope. She was a socialite in New York City, and I was one of the diverse CEOs to help name the child of this affluent Manhattan family who wanted their son to be president of the United States.
So, and what did they name him?
Oh, my gosh. What did they name that poor child? No, just kidding.
No, Napoleon.
It was actually, it was a great family, actually, and the process was amazing, where they had us, watch a woman walk in with a baby in her arms and say, so there's this name for the baby. And then had like this teenager come in. What happens in his teen years? And then, now you see this young man come in. Does that name still work? So the cute name that fit the baby didn't fit the guy when he was in middle school or high school, and
right.
didn't fit the guy when he was a man to be president, and vice versa. And it really made us think out of the box. And one of the names was on the list was Tucker, and I thought, Tucker, is this an odd name?
Tucker.
But all the ladies on the panel said, I like Tucker. The guys were like, sounds like my mechanic.
Yeah, it sounds like the movie about the guy that created the car.
Yes.
Tucker, yeah.
Yeah, Steven. But that was like too old and regal, I remember some of the people were saying. And Bodie was one of the names. I mean, it was pretty cool.
Bodie has become kind of popular, actually. Yeah. I've seen that. And I've seen it spelled a couple different ways. The kind of the East Asian way and the Southern American way. Like Bodie. Yeah. Hey, yo, Bodie. So there are lots of things out there on your horizon. Just so many, so many. Will you come back again sometime and bring us up to date?
Absolutely. I'll bring back some information about some of our feature film projects, and we'll go a little deeper into some of those things. And we'll share some more about thedailylifecoach.com and also Powered Up.
I can't wait. And Victor, I wish you every success with your documentary, putting the toe in the water, documentary projects and so forth. And any way we can help you, you know we will.
Thank you.
And thank you always for being an amazing part of the creative community that we all thrive on here in Sarasota and Manatee and Hillsborough counties and beyond. Globally at this point.
It's an honor. Thank you.
Thank you for all of it. And thanks for being here. And to all of you, thanks for listening. Listen again next time. Bye for now. I want to thank you for listening. I'm Jeannie Corcoran, your Sarasota County, Florida Film Commissioner. And if you want to get a hold of me, you can go to www.filmsarasota.com or you can call us toll free from wherever you are at 888-765-5777, extension 104. We're easy to get a hold of. And we like email. You can email us at info@filmsarasota.com, and we check all of our email. If you don't hear back from us right away, it's not that we haven't gotten it, but we might have a computer glitch. I hate to admit it, but it happens a lot. We've had emails that disappear for a month. We've had phone messages that disappear for 2 months, but they show up eventually. So we will get a hold of you. Or you can get a hold of us, ask us questions, and if we can help you, we will. And if we can't, maybe we can steer you in a good direction to somebody who will help you. And that's it for me. I'm Jeannie Corcoran, and you've been listening to Entertain You on the Radio Ear Network. And this is the Society Bites Network of Programs. Thanks for listening. Talk to you again soon.